We talked about the violence, we've talked about this behavior. How do you think all this is affecting the Church of Scientology?
I got to tell you, I really think that it's the Titanic is hitting the iceberg. I mean, it's not only that, there's a number of other factors. There's the fact that while all this sort of sadism is being played out by Miscavige up at Int, it's been years since he's allowed any form of management to actually take place. Like, nothing emanates, no evaluations, no strategies, no major programs emanates out of that place beyond his own pet programs. And this has been going on for years and years. It went on for 4, 5, 6 years before I left. It was one of the reasons why I left. It's just nothing but destructivity. And I've subsequently learned from people who have left since that it's gotten even worse. I mean, nothing emanates out of that place. And so you've got archaic finance systems. You've got finance systems in place at the organizations all across the United States where it's not viable for a person to be a staff member. It's unaffordable to move up the Scientology bridge through auditing or training because the prices are too exorbitant and they don't match what would be affordable to a regular working person, which Hubbard had worked out a whole formula for. He won't let any of these things happen. So in essence, you've got the doors soldered shut to the organizations. And in effect, you have a cult being created because Miscavige just keeps coming up with new gimmick after new gimmick to cannibalize off the same public. And it's gotten pretty extreme. I'll tell you how extreme it is. I mean, here I am putting a little one-page web page up, offering my help. Tom, I'm hearing from people that are on lines at Flag now. I mean, that's unheard of 10 years ago. I know what's going on over there.
And what are the people, those people, these are parishioners, right?
Yeah.
What are they saying?
Things like, it's now standard practice that if you ever get sent to ethics, like one of these OT7 people who are out doing their solo auditing, and they come into Flag for their 6 months check, and something comes up like they have some ethics problem, they get to the ethics officer, and it's standard operating procedure. We need you to buy another one of these book packages. They've already bought the new books, $3,000 for a set, right? Well, now you got to buy another one as amends and send it to a library. It's just like they keep going back to the well again and again and again with the same people.
But on the surface, do you see? I mean, the church just spent $40 million on its the Fort Harrison Hotel. You see a lot of money being spent. That seems to go at odds with what you're saying that things are going downhill.
Oh, they've got so much stashed away, and like I said, he's going back to the well again and again and again with the same people. They get him to make donations for no exchange. You're going to make donations for no service. Donate for this building campaign. Donate for this renovations campaign. I mean, they had that whole superpower campaign going on where the people are donating millions and millions of dollars. Mm-hmm. They're building funds.
So are they living to some extent off reserves, long-time reserves?
I think it's a combination of that plus they've got the captive public that he does have just keeps coming up with more donations. All I'm saying is this. I know for a fact that the statistics internationally, and it's a well-known fact within Scientology management, that from 1990 until December 2004 when I left, the statistics were on a grade like I'm talking about here. Every year prior to that, I'm talking about the delivery statistics, amount of well-done auditing hours, intensives completed, levels completed, even donations, okay? For every year, up to 3 years after L. Ron Hubbard's death, you had a steady upward progress for decades. 1990, when he took total control and Pat Broker was taken out, it's been like the St. Moritz slide. It's just a complete, uninterrupted downward trend, okay? Mm-hmm. But in that same period of time, there's been all these other gimmicky things. Like Golden Age of Tech, you now got to redo all your training. Golden Age of Tech for OTs, now you got to redo all your OT7 auditing. New books, you now got to all buy new book packages, and everything you ever read before, you never really got, and you never really got anything out of Scientology in the first place until you redo these books again. And incidentally, you need to buy 5 other copies for, to send into libraries. The IAS is doing all this other stuff for, you know, Scientologists, and they're running these campaigns. You need to donate to them. There's all these donate things, but it's a captive public is what I'm saying to you. Now, sure, there's new people coming in, but it's just nowhere near. Listen, if the statistics were like the type they're portraying at the events, they wouldn't have 40% capacity going on over at the Fort Harrison. I mean, it's a static. They're scavenging off and cannibalizing off a captive public.
When you were last in the organization, when was the last time you saw these statistics? How would you have occasion to actually see these statistics?
They're on all the computers at International Management at the end base.
So you would?
Yeah, every week you plug in at Thursday at 2 o'clock, and they're all tallied up, and you just go and they show you the whole graph. Mm-hmm. You can go 12 weeks, you can go 24 weeks, you can go 26 weeks, you can go 52 weeks, you can go 3-year graph, you can go 15-year, the whole thing. But Tom, this is such a well-known fact that graph, those graphs, those long-term since 1990, are pinned up on the wall up in International Management. I mean, that's a given fact. And I knew as of 2004, and I've had people leave who've been up there who tell me it never reversed, at least as of 2007.
And there's a name in Scientology for that kind of trend, right? What's that called?
That's emergency.
Emergency?
But over a long term, it becomes a danger. Emergency over a long period of time, mm-hmm. unchecked, meaning unreverted, turns into a danger.